As I always say, two heads are better than one.
Can you take out the trash?
Sure thing, Lois. Delighted to. I get tired when I stand.
Headlines. Two headlines are better than one. So I'm going to give you actually many, many more than two today. Specifically, subheadline. That will keep your prospect's eyes glued to your sales letter to where they can't even skim, man. And that means more sales. I'm going to show you how to write them today. I am John Benson. I'm here to help make you unignorable, and this is Sales Copy Secrets. Welcome back. And this is all about how to write attention-stealing headlines and the subheadline tricks that can really compel your prospects to take action, even if they're scrolling through super fast or thumbing down the page super fast. We can stop that. And once you stop that, oh, will your bank account ever say thank you in that exact high-pitched voice? Probably, because that's how all bank accounts talk. And as you know, my videos are all about sales copy and copywriting tips to help you improve your copywriting skills, become a copywriter, or just sell more online and become a better person. So here's why I want you to watch all the way to the end. I want to show you my mini sales page trick with subheadlines. And very few copywriters teach this technique, but once you see it, you will never be able to look at a sales page the same again. I'm going to show you one of my sales pages as the tutorial on this. And again, when you see it, the light bulbs will go off. And as always, if I have earned your like and respect by the end of this video, pulverize that like button, smash it, comment below, share this video with a friend, and be sure to ring that bell for notifications so you can be notified once new videos drop. Let's dive in. To write an effective subheadline, you first have to know what a headline is for, and it may not be so obvious at first. Ready? A headline's primary purpose is to get you to read the subheadline or the next sentence. I know that sounds so boring and lame and just unsexy, but it is the truth. Now, that being said, that is the prototypical definition of what you will hear a headline is for most copywriting teachers. I'm not most. I like to define things a little differently, so here's my definition. Ready? A headline serves to drive attention to the next sentence or section of a sales page, as well as create a strong desire to explore. More than just capturing attention, it captures imagination and instills hope, desire, or intrigue. Yeah, that sounds a lot sexier, doesn't it? Yeah. Also sounds a lot harder too, doesn't it? Yeah. Fortunately for you, you got me. And I'm going to help teach you some tricks to help make sure that you can do that. In fact, I already did teach you some tricks in the headline video below. You want to watch that after you watch this one so you can see how the first part of this went, how to create some really killer headlines that will do all of what I just described above. But today we're going to focus on subheadlines. And you can use some of these formulas for actual headlines as well, but our focus is still going to be on the subs. Cool? So what makes a subheadline? What is it? Why is it different than a headline? Well, a subheadline is used in one of two ways. First, as an explainer or clarification statement to the headline itself, and this is one that's rich in benefits. Often you'll see one, two, or even three subheadlines under a headline, which is teasing the reader with more clear-cut reasons to read further. These subheadlines are far more specific, and they tend to avoid any ambiguous language. The second version or use of a subheadline is what I call sales page chapter headings. These serve to disrupt and recapture the attention of the prospect and can often be non-specific, highly intriguing, and even more puzzling in nature. And as you probably have gathered, the formulas for writing the first version of the subheadline are completely different than the second headline. So we're going to cover several today, both positive and negative in origin, and we're going to have a lot of fun doing it. So let's dive in. And for our example, I decided to use something that's completely serious, absolutely not funny at all, and completely non-controversial in the slightest.
Help me. I can't poop.
Okay. I saw that headline and I just cracked up. Now, this headline's changed over the couple of years, but it's still roughly the same. And yeah, it's, hey, biology, what are we going to do, right? So this is clearly written to a specific target audience, and I don't have to tell you what that audience is struggling with, do I? But let's look at that from the lens of my definition of what a headline is, as well as the traditional definition of a headline. We'll do the traditional first. Did this get you to read the subheadline? Probably so. Now, I know you can't see it yet, but you probably want to read the subheadline because it basically got your attention. And again, this would only get your attention if you are the avatar. Now, you are the student here, so it probably has your attention anyway. But if you were the avatar, if this was something that you were struggling with, Boom, this would capture your attention in a heartbeat. So that part of the definition has been fulfilled. But what about my more elaborate, definitely much more cerebral, intelligent, brilliant, I dare say, definition? Well, does it create a strong desire to explore more? Yes, because it's almost like a story. It's in quotes. It unfortunately engages your imagination probably a little bit too much, but there is a sense of hope in that with the word help me, because you know what's coming next. There's going to be something to clarify that help, and that's where the subheadlines come in and completely make this work. Ready? Newly discovered enzyme eases the problem of constipation within minutes, no matter your age or medical history. Now, I'm going to put a caveat here. These are fictitious. I took them from existing real sales pages, and of course, I'm going to show you my real sales page toward the end of the video. But the reason I did this is for tutorial purposes, so I could more easily break out the formulas for you. But these are very close to what these real pages had. I just didn't want to use their copy without their consent. Make sense? So when you see that subheadline, newly discovered enzyme, you're automatically intrigued. Now that really hammers home that intrigue factor that I want to see in a headline, but I'm using these to work together. So the subheadline and headline work as one unit. So the headline has a thicker, richer definition to it now. I'm going to break these into formulas here in a moment, but first I want to show you the second headline that goes under this one. Ready? Unearthed deep in the jungles of Antarctica. Okay, sorry. I wrote that and I said, I have to keep it, jungles of Antarctica, because I clearly want to get across the point that this is a fictitious product that doesn't exist. It's based on a real one, but I'm having a little fun with it. Cool. This little life-changing molecule dubbed the poopzyme, I do love that one though. I think they should probably steal it. Is giving folks back their flat tummies, returning rapid and easy digestion, and making the bathroom a pleasant experience once again. Okay, that's a very long subheadline, but you see this all the time on sales pages. And I'm going to break down that whole formula. Believe it or not, the formula is a lot simpler than it seems at first glance. But you can use this to write your own subheadlines, and they work really well. Now let's look at a less optimistic topic, shall we say. And we'll go with actually one of the greatest VSLs ever written, and it is The End of America. Now, The End of America did not originally have all these subheadlines underneath it. I wrote these for this tutorial video. Ready? See how recent changes to our monetary debt system can radically alter the course of your retirement plan and send the United States economy into a 100-year collapse. Boy, that's cheery. That's pretty damn chipper. But if you were in that area where you're close to retirement and you're worried about this stuff, you think I got your attention? I got your attention with The End of America. I got your intrigue and your curiosity. There's no hope there. There's fear, right? But I got your attention with that. Or should I say Mike Palmer got your attention with that because he's the guy that wrote it. But I definitely got your attention with that subheadline. Because again, see how much more specific the subheadline is and how it makes the headline much more clear, but doesn't give away anything too specific, so the intrigue factor is there. Now let's do a second subheadline underneath that one. Ready? You must act now if you want to retire comfortably and protect your family's future. Urgency, benefit, all right there in the subheadline. Really good. Okay, so we have positive subheadlines and we have negative subheadlines. Let's look at the positive formulas first. Ready? First, we had the subheadline underneath, help, I can't poop, which said, newly discovered enzyme eases the problem of constipation within minutes, no matter your age or medical history. Here is the formula that I used to create that headline. Breakthrough, plus mechanism, plus benefit, plus time, plus even if. Okay, the very first thing we see here is the breakthrough. What is the breakthrough? Breakthrough is just a phrase that you want to think of. Like you could literally use breakthrough just by itself. Breakthrough colon. You could use revealed colon. What did I use? Newly discovered. That was it. That's the breakthrough part, okay? The second part is the mechanism. In other words, what's the hook? What's the thing? What is the thing that's driving the product or service? In this case, it's an enzyme. All I said was enzyme, so I didn't have to say anything fancy, okay? Next up comes the benefit. What is the benefit to this newly discovered enzyme or breakthrough mechanism? In my case, it eases the problem of constipation. Next is time, because I want you to narrow this down to a time frame in as little as 30 days. In my case, within minutes, if it was 30 days, it wouldn't sell that well. But put a time frame on it if you can. If you can't, you can leave it off. And then there's the even if. Even if is like, you want to think of like, this will work even if. And in my even if, it's pretty simple. No matter your age or medical history. So that's the typical rebuttals that somebody might have to this offer. Well, I'm 85. Or well, I've got 18 diseases. Well, this works in case you have, if you're 95 with a million diseases. Doesn't matter, it still works. So that's my even if. All right, let's move to the second one. Unearthed deep in the jungles of Antarctica. Yeah, lots of jungles in Antarctica, folks. This little life-changing molecule dubbed the poopzyme is giving folks back their flat tummies, returning rapid and easy digestion, and making the bathroom a pleasant experience once again, explanation point. Wow, that was a long subheadline. Let's look at the formula behind it. There is a formula, and it's a lot shorter than the subheadline. Ready? Origin, plus teasing descriptor, plus mechanism, plus optional hook, that is optional, plus benefits. That's it. That's the entire formula for that whole long sentence. I'll show you. Ready? Origin is like an origin story, like he was born on the dark side of Chicago or something to this effect. Okay. Well, what did I say? Unearthed in the jungles of Antarctica. Now, that did require some copywriting expertise, I will admit. But you can do this, even if you said found in Antarctica. So that's boring copy, found in Antarctica, okay, or found in Peru. But that is an origin, and you put it together with the formula, and you'll end up with a really good subheadline. What is a teasing descriptor? It's a phrase I use a lot, like this little, or this little known, or this powerful. It's something that teases what the thing is. And I like the word little molecule, like this little molecule. And the molecule, by the way, is the next part of that because that's the mechanism. The mechanism is a molecule. Enzyme, molecule, I'm using those interchangeably. Now, I could have said this little life-changing enzyme, but I thought that sounded too repetitive. So all I did was go to relatedwords.io and looked up enzyme. And guess what? I could find a whole bunch of related words to enzyme and molecule work just fine. You're welcome for that tip. Now, there's an optional hook in here. You don't have to do this, but I love hooks. I create them for a living. So I called it the poopzyme, okay? It might not be the best hook I've ever created, but it's damn sure the funniest. And the only word I threw in there that was copywriter-esque is dubbed, okay? It's this little life-changing molecule dubbed the poopzyme, and that's pretty cool. And then we just get into a string of benefits. That's all I did was put benefits together. Ready? Is giving folks back their flat tummies, okay? Because when you're constipated, your belly's probably bigger. So I thought, hey, flat tummy, that's something else somebody wants, right? Returning rapid and easy digestion. Obviously, they want that because that's part of the problem. And making the bathroom a pleasant experience once again, you know, like it used to be when you were 14 or whatever. I don't know that that's ever how I thought about it, but apparently the people in this demographic do. All right, let's dive into our negative subs and I'll break those formulas down for you here. Let's look at the subheadline for the end of America. See how recent changes to our monetary debt system can radically alter the course of your retirement plan and send the United States economy into a 100-year collapse. Oh my God, we're gonna die. All right, but that's got only three parts to the formula. Ready? See how, literally the word see how, unique event, direct pain. That's it. Those are the three parts of that formula. I'll show it to you. See how, that's hard, right? Unique event, recent changes to our monetary debt system. So all I had to know was what is the recent thing that just happened that's going to cause this pain, okay? So that's what you have to find. What just happened? Is there anything in the past year or two that just happened that you can attach to the painful thing that you're about to comment on? Because once you do that and you can say recently, oh, it's huge. See how recent changes to our monetary system, not changes, recent changes. You can apply that across any niche or industry. And then I just have a series of direct pains. Okay, what is that going to cause? Okay, it's going to radically alter the course of your retirement plan. It's going to send the United States economy into a 100-year collapse. So I have two big pain points. And granted, those took a little bit of writing, but I could have written those in a lame way and it still gets most of the benefit of that subheadline across. And the next one is also just three steps. And this one's a lot easier to write. Ready? You must act now if you want to retire comfortably and protect your family's future. So that's negative in the sense that there's urgency, like it's related to something that's very negative, the fall of the American economy and all that stuff. But it's actually quite positive. It's sounding right. Secure your family's future. But let's look at what I'm doing here. Action plus if plus desires. It's so simple, right? What's the action? You must act now. That was the action. I know, really hard. You must act now. That's the action that I want them to take. Now, this part's really tricky. If. You have to write the word if. I know I'm such a taskmaster. And I actually made you write two additional words. If you want. I'm so sorry. So I have now. You must act now if you want what? To retire comfortably and protect your family's future. Benefits, desires, whatever you want to call them. Desires is what I call them here. I desire to retire comfortably. I desire to protect my family's future. That's all I did. I wrote two of them. Done deal. Now let's look at the second and by far and away the most abundant use of the subheadline. It's what I call sales page chapter headings, and you'll see why I call it that in a moment. Now these serve to break up and stop the scroll. You wanna stop the scroll. That's super, super important. That's what the purpose of these subheadlines are for. With each subheadline having enough curiosity, intrigue, weirdness, you can throw all sorts of curveballs in this one, enough to stop the damn scroll. That's what you gotta do, that's your job. Now to illustrate how cool this can be, I'm gonna open up a design. It's actually not even live yet, for a brand new sales letter I just wrote. We're real excited to test this out. It's in the CBD oil niche. And I'm gonna show you how I wrote these subheadlines specifically to stop the scroll. Now, as we're going through this, I want you to notice how the subheadlines kind of make you stop. They're so out there, or they're so dynamic, or so wild. They're gonna make you stop and go, what is this section again? And remember, you gotta stop the scroll because your customer is not sold yet. And the longer they read, and the more they read, the more likely they are to buy. Okay, let's have a look. His doctor was stunned into silence. That is actually a pre-headline, okay? So pre-headlines, we'll get into another video, but that's the pre-headline. Normally they're in yellow bars, but we decided to make it a little bit more bold. The headline is "Secret of a 73-year-old mountain climber gives near instant relief from back and joint pain." Now, what's interesting about this is it does all of the things that I was talking about in my definition. It definitely gives you intrigue. It definitely gives you hope. You don't know what I'm talking about, the secret of a 73-year-old mountain climber, but it also makes you insatiably curious. How does a 73-year-old guy climb mountains? Don't you want to know? So we built that all into that very short, succinct headline. Let's look at the subheadline underneath it. "Forget about dangerous addictive medications, premium jacking prescriptions, pesky doctor appointments, over-the-counter pills that can trigger heart attacks, swallowing and gagging on horse-sized capsules." Obviously, I'm just all these horrible things that I know my audience hates that they can forget all about, but they're also very scary, right? So I'm doing two things at once here. And we actually have another one here that's completely the opposite. It's very positive. So what is this? This is duality. And I'm not going to take you through every subheadline on the page. That would take all day. I'm just going to point out a few. "Science has now solved a 25-year-old mystery, revealing a fix for chronic discomfort in aging joints found within the Dead Sea Scrolls." But you got a 73-year-old mountain climber, you got all the things that you don't have to do, and something about the Dead Sea Scrolls. My God, what on earth am I talking about? Well, that's what we're going to be revealed in these subheadlines. Ready? Oh, by the way, notice the self-identifying avatar, "Dear Fellow Sufferer." Now, that one's pretty clever, and I'll tell you why. Fellow Sufferer. In other words, I'm suffering too. So we're part of the same team. We're part of the same club. Now I'm gonna scroll through this pretty quickly and just show just a few things about the subheadlines I want you to jump out and pay attention to. "Hope and relief for the aches of aging." I like to use quotation marks in my subheadlines. I think that's a lot of fun. So when you do that, it definitely brings out attention, definitely draws attention to the subheadline even more. "The aches of aging," a good alliteration. "A life free from needless agony." Here's a quote. "You can dig your grave with either a bulldozer or a teaspoon. Either way, you end up 6 feet under." That quote comes out of nowhere. "An ancient remedy for our modern curse." I'm going to break down how I wrote that one in particular in the training in just a moment. "The pain reliever that boggles the mind." I got by with this on a compliance issue because the pain reliever is actually the nickname that I gave the guy who wrote the letter. So people call him the pain reliever. So he is the pain reliever. So I can say the pain reliever in quotes, and it's a compliance gray area that usually works. That's pretty clever if you ask me. "My own mother was in agony. I felt totally powerless, and everything changed the day I met a 73-year-old mountain climber called Speedy." Now, I'm gonna break this down starting from up here. And what I want to reveal is the secret beyond all secrets to subheadlines. There are numerous formulas in here. We'll get to those in just a moment. But I do wanna share this mini sales page secret. My subheadlines are actually creating a miniature sales page in the reader's mind. Even if they were to scroll and just read the subheadlines, they would get the general idea of the entire sales page. Look at what I'm talking about. "An ancient remedy for our modern curse, pain reliever that boggles the mind, my own mother was in agony, everything changed," so the story continues, "the day I met Speedy, the 73-year-old mountain climber, aging is only for the brave, Speedy's pain secret, a bizarre juice from a plant in Chile that we should never drink." So what? A juice that you shouldn't drink? What the hell? Do you rub it on? You don't know what it is, but that's a secret. "My dear wife took my anguish away," and so on we go. If you keep going down this page, you will see every single element of the actual sales page inside the subheadlines, and the subheadlines are written to evoke curiosity, intrigue, and basically force people to read every single section as much as one can force somebody to read something, and that means more sales. And thank you so much for watching this video, Attention Stealing Headlines Part 2, the subheadline trick. So in part two of this part two series on headlines, I'm actually going to break down three of the subheadlines on the page you just saw, and I'm going to reveal how I wrote them and what I was thinking and give you the formulas for those subheadlines so that you can use them too. But now you know the techniques for creating subheadlines that make a sales page into a mini sales page, and you know the importance of subheadlines, and you know quite a few formulas to write them for yourself. Okay, so be sure to like, share, subscribe, comment below, and do me a favor and ring that bell so you can be notified the moment my new videos drop. Cool? And a special note, I want to thank you so much for the rapid growth of this channel. It's still a very small channel at the time of this recording, but we are exponentially growing, and it's growing organically, so we're looking at hitting maybe 50,000 subs, cross our fingers, by the end of the year or thereabouts. And I want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart, because without you, that would not be possible. And I would really love it if you would share this video or this channel with a friend that you think could use it. Cool? My name is John Benson, and I am here to help make you unignorable.